Hey, hey, it's Stomara here. I'm stuck. I've been doing game dev for almost 3 years now, and it's been on and off, and I never feel like I know enough to make a decent game. And I'm sure you feel the same, and we need to change that. But how do we even do that? There is no better way to learn than start practicing. So many options though. Just not another platformer. No. So what game projects will actually be good for learning and improving your skills so you can finally develop a decent game and add it to your game dev portfolio? I decided to do some research on this and find those game ideas. So if you're interested in improving your skill in game dev and learning it with me, stay tuned. Before we dive into all those projects, I just want to say that these are projects that I'd like to make to improve my skills. I generally know what areas I need to work on more, but these projects will help you improve as well, since these are not 2D platformers that you've been making a lot lately. This is not your regular how to learn game dev. This is what to learn to get better. Well, we all have some kind of dream game that we spend a lot of time working on, but that's just one game, and the chances are you're missing out on a lot of possibilities. Spending time on different projects will help you discover new features of your game engine of choice, practice your problem solving, and add diversity to your game dev portfolio. Let's get to those projects. The first project idea that might be interesting is a card game. Yeah, I know, it's not the most exciting game project, but it's going to teach you how to do a few things. You're going to set up a turn-based game that possibly has lots of rules that you'd have to code. And you can also practice adding different effects to your game. I mean, it doesn't have to be a Hearthstone replica with their crazy graphics. Just try to make a few of those, and it would certainly make your game look better. One of the best projects that you can make to really step up your game is a Minecraft replica. I mean, as cliche as it sounds, this is actually one of the best projects to improve your skills. Let's look at what we have here. First and probably my favorite feature is multiplayer. It might be a little bit challenging if you haven't done anything like that before, but it's a good goal to move towards. I'm not saying to get everything done, just maybe start with positions of the players. If you're still intimidated by it, Minecraft has plenty interesting features to replicate, like a procedural generation of terrain. Knowing how to create an environment like that can certainly benefit your other projects, and it will look pretty good in your portfolio. In addition, you have plenty of other common mechanics for survival games, maybe even RPGs, a building system, crafting, fighting, etc. And I just want to mention the importance of optimizing things in a game like this. Our next candidate is a board game. You know those games that people used to play when they were bored and before video games came around? Yeah, tic-tac-toe, chess, those. It's actually very interesting to think about these games. Not the actual mechanics, it's just checking for the right moves. But the opponent AI of those games. It's a totally different question. If you actually look around this topic, you'll see that chess AI is not that easy. Yeah, who knew that replicating how our brain works is hard? Anyways, there are plenty of options to replicate. Tic-tac-toe and chess are just the most common ones, I think. And you can throw in some multiplayer in there too. You also just have to implement the difficulty levels for the game. The next project idea I got from the members of my Discord community. So if you're still not there, it's time you finally join. Don't miss out on the fun you're gonna have chatting with amazing, talented people there. Get help and share your work. I literally say this in every video and somehow the majority of you are still not there. So the project is a VR game. Any game, literally. VR is just a topic that's been moving forward for a while now. You can't exactly say that it's new, but it's definitely hot. And I bet it's going to look impressive that you know how to make a game like that. Besides improving your programming and technical knowledge of the game engine, you can also improve your game design skills. And a great game idea for that would be a puzzle game. There are so many tricks in game design that you can do to guide the player to the right solution. If you start looking into it, it literally feels like mind control. Yeah, people are so predictable. Just like me, because I'm gonna ask you to subscribe to my channel and hit that like button if you want to see more content from me. And all of that being said, I want to draw a conclusion. I want to mention just a few general things that you might be missing out on, but they're of utmost importance in any game development. The first one is clean code. It's not a game jam entry, you don't have to crunch things to write spaghetti code. Believe me, it's gonna do more for you in the long run. The next one is using source control, especially for teamwork. This is something that you can practice during a game jam, and clean code will certainly help you a lot on the journey. Working with other people is very important. While it is impressive to make a game all by yourself, you will be able to achieve great things together. That's all for this video. Thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed it. I certainly did enjoy making it. I want to thank everyone who supported me on Patreon and welcome new members, especially
Cam, Sosh Howell, Renan Weber, Micah Fetters, Dominic Domke, Jeff Lofton, Housen.
See you in the next video. Bye!